Hello, great to be here again, and can only join you on this. It's really a beautiful place to be. See quite a bit of familiar faces. People who know me know I'm a bit special. I like to break the rules a bit. Not in the sense that I completely go berserk and break the law, but sometimes it's time to bend it a bit. And I know that probably at least one or two of my colleagues are now freaking out. It's like, why is he on this slide deck and not on the company one? Yeah. You know, why not? Let's try something different. Let's do something new. And some of you are also wondering, it's like, why isn't there just like a title slide, opening slide, as you're used to? You're kind of programmed that you expect the title slide. So there we go. Here's my title slide. Actually, looking at it, there's not much new on it, right? Jan already introduced me, so you know who I am. Jan introduced the title. You've seen me stand up. I work for the Ripe NCC. Well, here's our company logo. It's also next to the screen. So there's a date. Oh, joy. Well, that's useful information, right? In case you forgot where you are, you're at the SEE6 meeting, and it's Monday, 12 June. Why am I telling you this? Actually, the only real purpose of these kind of slides, these title slides, is to indicate a starting point. So let's start. Confession time. I love advertising. In this kind of audience, you know, it's a dirty word. Advertising, marketing, sales, we don't like it. Tend to stay away from it. We don't want sales talks, we want techie talks. As I said, I like advertising. I like to see how these things work. In that sense, I like it from a technical perspective. What makes a campaign work? What doesn't work? How can it be that in that millions of messages that we get every day, some of them are still effective? And I say some, because advertising comes in three different types. You have the really good, the really bad, and the stuff that does absolutely nothing. And that's David Ogilvy, one of the original Mad Men, once said, that's about 99%. 99% of the advertising is absolutely nothing. And I think he's right. Think about it. When you came here this morning, how many advertising messages did you pause? How many billboards? How many flyers? How many things on your screens flew by that you completely ignored? So we always say we're proud of it a bit. We're immune to that stuff. We're immune to advertising. Why am I telling you this? Well, I think presentations at conferences like this are about the same. There are the really good, and the really bad, and there's 99% of the presentations that you go, eh. What's in it for me? Nothing. Why am I listening to this? Totally not relevant. Most of the time, when you watch a presentation, it's what's in it for me. And that's basically also what advertising tries to address. If I try to sell you something, it means that I need to address some specific improvement. Whether I'm cheaper as my competition, whether I'm better as my competition, even the age-old laundry detergent advertisements that we all love to hate, it's basically, I'm wider, I'm cheaper, and it's more efficient, whatever. And the same goes for every presentation you watch. Every presentation also, well, at least if it's a good one, has a call to action. You need to do something. Whether you need to buy a product, install some software, reconfigure your network, there's always something that you want to do. And you're only going to do that if it's beneficial to you. You're not going to do it if you lose something. Let's be honest. So, and a lot of times, like I said, these presentations go on yapping about stuff that you really don't need, that don't show any improvement. And you go home, and you basically just do nothing. You go out, have a coffee, or read your email. So, what's the key then? Well, the key is, I need something to stand out. What people say, a unique selling point in marketing terms. This is why you're improving if you do this. The key word really is being unique. As I said, you want to stand out. And as much as you don't like sales and as much as you don't like advertising probably, you're about the same. You're doing the same thing because you're just selling internet connectivity. And there are many more like you. why do the customer pick you? Cheaper, better quality. Maybe it's because they like your face. Maybe it's because you hired some famous people that people identify with, and that's why they like you. But every time you go about it, whether it's advertising or presentations, it's that unique point, that USP, that you're trying to address. And that's what gets people moving. You need to be a bit special to stand out. Let me give you an example. Here's some really special person. The hipster. Love it. Big beard. Oh man, he is so special. He is so unique. He likes to stand out. And picked him as an example because what I, when I was preparing, found some Dutch market research. It says that 30% of the people in the Netherlands who bought a vinyl record last year, remember those old plastic discs with music printed on them? They don't even own a device to play them. That's interesting. This guy is marketer's dream. He's buying all that old stuff that we've completely written off. Let's be honest, we thought, you know, vinyl records were gone with the CD and everything is online now, MP3. Why bother? They started buying that stuff again. Can you imagine you sit on that record machine that printed records? Completely useless stuff, completely written off. We're now to the point that people buy them. Well, they can't listen to them, so basically you're no longer printing music carriers, you're carrying ornaments, I don't know. He likes to stand out. He likes to be seen carrying vinyl records around. He likes to hang them from his wall. So sure, he can't listen to them. But anyway, whole new life to what was once written off industry. It's really cool. Now, the reason he probably buys it, because he thinks he's really special. Look at me. I'm standing out. I'm really special. And so does all his friends. In fact, yes, they're all very special. Look at them. Really, all unique individuals. That's the trick of marketing. It's to address you personally, make you feel special. Make you do the stuff I want you to do. And then make sure that everybody in his own right feels so special he starts doing it, and I create a mass market. I create a majority. Right now you think like, oh God, what is he on about? Why is he blabbing around advertising at this type of conference? Well, basically the same thing. I'm here to sell you something. You're asking yourself, what's in it for me right now? Okay, well, let's be honest. Here's my product, IP version 6. I used to do IP version 4, but long gone. Don't have it anymore. You can ask, but sorry, I'm out. And I've got this wonderful, shiny, new stuff. It's called IP version 6. And it's bigger, it's better, it's cheaper. I've got much more of it. You can ask as much as you like. I'm sure we can fulfill that order. I have a chat with my colleagues in the hallway. Some people even say it's faster. Now, that's a bit of a debatable claim. I'm not going to talk about it right now. But with all these properties, you would think that's a really easy sell, right? Here you go. You know, sorry, IPv4 sold out, but I've got this wonderful, better, new product. Let me ask you a question. Who here in the room is from the region and is actually doing IPv6 towards his customers? Okay, quite a few. Well, then all of you are pretty darn unique. Because this is the IPv6 statistics of the region. 0. Just to explain this graph, red is bad, green is good. There's about 25% of IPv6 in Portugal, there's about 25-30% of IPv6 in Greece. Anything in the middle is just one big 0. Kudos to Jan. If you really zoom into the picture, you'll see that Slovenia is slightly more orange than everything around it. But it's just. So yes, you are really unique. Here I am, Madman, trying to turn this red into green. That's my mission. Yes, and I'm pretty mad, as Jan said. I've been doing this for the last 15 years. Well, actually, doing this for the last 15 years, we've got various rates of success in various countries. but it's not as grim as it looks when you look at sort of the rest of Europe. Some countries fall behind, and it's not only Southern Europe. You see Sweden and Denmark is not doing that bad. In fact, I'm from the Netherlands, and it's also a bit of a dark blob there. It's, I don't know, I can't get these people to move. We keep hammering about. But general, it's picking up. It's not a really mass market, but this is sustainable. This is doing something. Which brings me to the following question. Because I've been going on about IPv6 and many of my colleagues for at least the last 6 SE meetings and many more, many other events in this region where we go about and talk about IPv6. I was here in Montenegro 2 years ago, and while we were basically discussing setting up an IXP, I also really addressed the need to go IPv6. We make sure that IXP from day one was IPv6 capable. Be aware. Train people, we went here for training courses, etc. Which kind of begs me the question, what's not in it for you? It's better, it's faster, it's cheaper, yet you're not picking up. Is it because you have enough IPv4 then? Because my market research shows that not really. This is a growing market. We saw Pavel's presentation. And for sure, you can't get any more IPv4 out of us. So I'm not sure how you're going to connect those customers, but it's going to be a difficult story. Is it then that the technology is not available? I also find it hard to believe. Of course, there's always difficult corner cases with legacy equipment or stuff that needs upgrading. But in general, you see all across Europe, people are doing IPv6. So if you really want to, it can be done. You are indeed a pretty special bunch. It all looks so easy, and you're not doing anything. So I can go and stand here again and tell you to do IPv6, like I did already. But yeah, what's in it for me? Clearly, I'm missing the mark. I'm part of that 99%. We go out, have a coffee, and next year we're back, telling you exactly the same thing. So instead, as we do go out and coffee, I've got one question for you. Find me, or find one of my colleagues, and tell me what do you need to start IPv6 deployment. To steal a quote from Steve Crocker, I'm Marco, I work for the RIPE NCC, and I'm here to help. Tell us what you need. We can hopefully address those needs. We can help you deploy IPv6. That's what I'm here for. Happy to take any of these answers now. You can also always mail me, marco@ripe.net, and otherwise find me during one of the coffee breaks that should be starting really soon now, I think. Right?
Thank you. Okay, are there any questions?
Answers. I'm looking for answers, but
there are fully functional mics. If you have questions, go to the mics now. No?
Yeah, no, there's somebody.
Don't be shy, we don't bite.
Nope.
Okay. So maybe you explained it so well that everything is clear. I have no
idea. I love to go back here next year and celebrate that it's all green map.
Exactly. So, who in this room is deploying IPv6 in their network? Hands up.
We had a few here in the middle, I think. Yes. See?
Okay. What about the others? What are you waiting for? Okay. So after this talk, I'm sure people will start deploying it. Thank you, Marco.
Okay. Thank you.